And James had his hand up as well. So, Councilman Wright.
Yes, I passed out a document to council, and I am not in favor of this. James had decided to talk about a misery of the tax, and I can appreciate us wanting to follow the law and apply the law, especially in a situation like this where we're talking about our school system and it means so much to so many people. But when you look at the code section that was cited in this ordinance that you're asking us to rubber stamp tonight, it says that when the citizens of a municipality wishes to annul their school system, that they should be the one who initiate that process. That's the first concern that I have. This was not initiated by the citizens. This was initiated by a group that got citizens involved. That's the first concern. Also, code section 20-2-291 talks about the financing and construction of these voluntary mergers, consolidation, how that will happen. And some of the criteria that they set forward says that no student shall be expected to or required to travel a greater time than the maximum time prescribed by the State Board of Education. We have more information on how far these children are going to travel, where they're going to have to travel, what they're going to have to do. That same code section, E1, says the local board of education will potential parties to emerge of the local school system consolidation has to approve a resolution to send to the State Board of Education to ask them to conduct a feasibility study. Now, I got curious when I saw this and I called. I called the State Board, I represented them, did the same. I said, has the state been requested, has a resolution from our local board been sent asking them to conduct a feasibility study on consolidation of schools? She said she was not aware of no such study, no such feasibility study. I called our local board of education, remember my local board, asked them the same question. They said that, I don't know if it's the same report, it was a feasibility study did in 1990, but it was not done by the State Board. And it said it was not approved in terms of consolidation, that we should not consolidate. The local board passed the local board of education. And I find this, you know, how we missed all this, and this is what the local board of education has to approve a resolution asking the State Board to conduct a feasibility study. The State Board conducts that feasibility study, and the local board has to approve it. Now, if that has happened, then we can go forward. But think about the law, the context of the city of Valdosta, and other things that we put out here. I would encourage this council to consider this here, that the State Board has not conducted a feasibility study, that the local board has not conducted a feasibility study. As far as I know, no feasibility study has been conducted. This is a very sensitive issue, and I'm pretty sure either way it goes, somebody's going to be filing a lawsuit, but we should decide on the caution of the law. And this is what is stated in the statute. Now, if somebody does something different, if there's something written, I understand, you know, what we think will happen and what might happen. But what I'm saying is these are the statutes that are written by the Georgia statute that says these steps need to be taken. And nobody can tell us how far our kids are going to